Amigos, ¿cómo están? Una edición más de Auto 060 aquí en Cristina Radio Network. Y tenemos un show lleno de noticias, de información, de entrevistas muy interesantes. Y vamos a empezar con una de ellas, hablando sobre el nuevo estudio de J.D. Power and Associates para conocer lo que está pasando con lo que está pasando con los autos que prefiere los consumidores aquí en Estados Unidos. So now we're gonna switch back to English because we have David Sarins from J.D. Power and Associates. How are you?
I'm well. How are you?
Thank you very much for having the time to spend with us to talk about the 2013 J.D. Power and Associates Automotive Performance Execution and Layout Appeal Study. So great news for Porsche, I guess. But it's not new news. They've been in the number one for a long time, huh?
They have. This is the ninth year in a row that Porsche has led the study. Obviously we're measuring the appeal of vehicles, and clearly, you know, it's an area where Porsche has historically performed extremely well.
And I guess the answer is kind of obvious, but can you give us a little bit why is the reason that they've been in the number one for such a long time?
Yeah, I mean, it's a combination of things. Obviously, the owners really love the performance of the vehicles, that's clear. But also they like the practicality of the vehicles. For, you know, considering the performance, the vehicles are typically very practical. They have a lot of nice features. They often have surprisingly amount of storage inside them. I mean, you can get a set of golf clubs in a box there. And the interiors are nicely executed. And so really across the board, you know, they're sports cars, but you can use them every day.
Yeah. And even though that some people have criticized Porsche years ago when they introduced the Cayenne as the first SUV, and now they even say that it's the sports cars manufacturer because most of their sales are actually SUVs. I mean, they're still, very appealing to everybody, right?
They are, and the Cayenne performs well as well. I mean, people in that segment really like that vehicle. Yes, it was a little controversial when they introduced it, but they sell a lot of them, and the owners are very satisfied with the Cayenne.
Yeah, and now they're coming up with a smaller version, the Macan, that is coming next year, so probably they're going to keep being in that top of your list for this study. But there are other good news for the Germans and the Americans. The Volkswagen Group came out with big awards in this list, right?
Yeah, the Volkswagen Group again has, and that does include Porsche. They historically have performed very well in the study. Audi owners appreciate the vehicles very much. In fact, Audi was the second ranked brand in the study, right behind Porsche. And then in the, you know, mass market, Volkswagen is also historically one of the best performers in that segment. So really across all three brands, they're doing very well.
Yeah, and the Americans, Chevrolet came up with some awards too. And interestingly enough, I mean, for second year in a row, the same vehicles ranked very well, the Avalanche, the Sonic, and the Bolt, right?
Yes, they all led their segments last year, and they all led their segment again this year, which is a little unusual because often with appeal, what we find is, as a vehicle starts to be on the market for several years, you know, better competitors come out and overtake them. But with the Volt, the Sonic, and the Avalanche, so far no competitor has managed to overtake them. Now, the Avalanche is in its last year of production, so next year somebody else has to win that segment.
Yeah, there's going to be a change there. Right. So, David, can you please explain a little bit how the study is done? Because, I mean, you said like the owners voting this, but can you go on a little bit in detail about how it's done?
Yes, we select owners to participate in the study. We get the vehicle registrations directly from the from a company who get them directly from the government registration. So this is a pre-selected known sample of customers. We invite them to take an online survey, and about 80,000 consumers took part in the online survey across more than 200 different models. And basically we asked them to evaluate their vehicle on more than 70 different attributes. So it includes styling, engine performance, transmission performance, fuel economy, the interior of the vehicle, the audio entertainment navigation system, the seats, the HVAC system. So across the whole vehicle, we asked them to give their vehicle a rating from 1 to 10. And then we sum up the scores across all of those evaluations, and the vehicles with the highest scores come out on top.
Yeah, so the scale goes to up to 1,000 points, and Porsche got 884. And the average in the industry is 795. What does it mean for people who see their cars or the cars that are considering that are below the average?
What it means is that owners of those vehicles are expressing, you know, slightly less satisfaction than the average. It doesn't mean that the vehicles are not good vehicles, because, you know, frankly, almost any new vehicle today is going to be pretty good. But there's different degrees of good. What we do find is that less expensive vehicles tend to get lower scores. So for consumers, it's important to look at how the vehicle they're interested in competes with or compares with other vehicles within the same segment. So not so much to look at the overall brand rankings, but to look at the individual model scores, and that will give them a better idea.
Yeah. And I mean, not surprising, Kia, Hyundai come around that segment, but they have made huge strides in the recent years, right?
They really have. You know, many years ago, the brands didn't perform very well in the study, but certainly over the last 5 to 10 years, some of the new products they brought out have been very competitive, if not, you know, segment leading. I mean, a good example is the Kia Optima. It led the segment last year. It came second behind the Passat this year, and you know, it's a very, very strong product and very competitive in that mid-sized car segment, which is a very strong segment, and the Hyundai Sonata also. But really, across their whole product lineup, they have a very competitive set of products now, and can stand up against any of the, you know, domestics or the Japanese.
Yeah. Well, David Sergeant from J.D. Power and Associates, we have published the link to our own report on the study, but where can people find out more about J.D. Power and Associates, about this and any other studies that you do?
Sure. If they go to www.jdpower.com, they'll find all of the information about all of the studies we do.
Well, thank you very much, David, for the time and the information, and let's see if we talk next year again and we see Porsche there on the top again.
I wouldn't be surprised.
Thank you very much again.
Okay, all right.
Bye.
Bye-bye.